What is up, fellow YouTube artists and aspiring artists? My name is Mike with Aristotle Custom Spray Paint Art, and today we're going to be doing a forest scene. If you're new to the channel, like many of you are, thanks for following along and subscribing. Hopefully these videos are giving you something beneficial, helping you to further your art or get into art or inspire you to do some, or maybe just like watching at home. Either way, I really appreciate all of the views and the subscribers that I've been getting lately. Life has been quite hectic lately. We've moved into an RV to facilitate an art tour that we're going on. We're gonna be living in this thing full time, traveling around to different markets, festivals, and art events to try to promote my artwork, grow my subscribership, and make some strides in the art world. With living in an RV comes some struggles, especially when it comes to YouTube. Number one being that I have very crappy internet access at current. I am working a job still up until we leave, which is about 1 month from now, as well as painting at several markets, festivals, and different events each week. This has been taking up a ton of time for me. I've tried to facilitate filming while at the markets and festivals to be able to kind of kill two birds with one stone. But you gotta talk to a lot of people, you gotta stop, you gotta be a salesman as well. The markets have been great. I'm making lots of money as I transition into being a full-time professional artist. But YouTube has suffered a little bit. I made a pact to myself to make a video every single day for a month and post it. And the results have varied. I had a pretty good run of doing a video pretty much every day. Part of that was to gather data on what the best times of day, best days of the week to post videos were, what types of videos that you guys like the most. I did get some data from that. It's helped me kind of understand a little bit of when and what to post. But the time has come. I need some feedback. I need some help. And that comes from you, the viewers. If you guys just started watching these videos, you just stumbled across this video, or you've been subscribing since day one, I need to hear from you guys. Leave me a comment down below and let me know what's been most beneficial for you in this channel. Do you like the tutorials? Do you like the time-lapse videos? Is there something I'm not currently doing that you'd like to see? The main goal of my channel is to inspire people to get started in spray paint art, teach people the basics of how to get started, as well as bring those of you who are somewhat in the middle up to a more advanced level, and hopefully inspire you guys to get out there, share your art with people, make some money off it, sell some paintings, and step outside of your comfort zone. That being said, you as the viewer need to tell me the best way to do that. If it's tutorials, the time-lapse videos, or something else altogether, please let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. I want to cater this channel to what you guys want to see. So make sure you drop a comment below. Let me know what you think. And that'll help me to make better content for you guys. Enough of the rant. I know it's painful. This is probably not what you clicked on the video to see. We're going to do a forest scene today. So let's get into the painting. So today we're rocking out a forest scene. For this, we're gonna throw down some green for our background color. Here I'm using some neon paint. We're gonna go in with a torch just to set the paint. Make sure you do this part outside. It is not safe. You could also use a hairdryer. I just do that to set the paint when I'm using scraping techniques so that when I scrape paint off, it's not just a white background underneath. I'm gonna go in, add some light green, dark green, and some white, and then roll in with our plastic bag just to create some background textures. Once we've got that part sorted out, we're going to go in with some green lines here in the shape of our trees and some black as well. Definitely don't overthink it. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're just adding a bit of shadow base for our actual scraping. Little dot in the center here for some light coming in. And we're going to go in with our palette knife and start scraping paint away to create our trees. The black and green that we put on is going to give a little bit of color, shadow, depth and texture. So we're going to go and do most of the trunks here. Definitely taking note where our light source is coming from. So when I switch to the other side, I'm essentially scraping the other part of the tree. Moving on, we're going in to add some branches. If you guys are getting sticky paint that's not wanting to come off when you're using the scraping technique, make sure you use some clear coat to loosen things up a bit. Another pro tip, when you're using a palette knife for the scraping and removing paint, don't use too much pressure. If you're pushing really hard down on your paper, you're pushing too much. If you're having issues getting a nice clean line, make sure your palette knife is free from existing paint. To do that, you can spray some clear coat on and use sandpaper to remove the excess, and you'll be good to go. Over our black here, we just do some light green and do the mountain technique to pull off some paint and give us a base for our foreground. From here, we're going to take a paintbrush and spray some black spray paint onto an existing piece of poster board or the lid of a spray can, whatever the case may be. And then we're going to go in and paint on our trees for the foreground. Before we do that, we add some shadows into the foreground terrain here, as well as some highlights using the same palette knife technique as the trees. We're going to go in and paint our trees over top here. Of our bright trees in the background, they're closer to the light source. We're going to move in with our darker black trees and paint those in. When you're painting trees, there's no right or wrong. They're one of the easiest things to paint because they come in all sizes, shapes, and forms. So just do what feels right, do what looks visually pleasing to you, and you'll be good to go. Go in and add some bases to the trees here and some branches. For paintbrushes, guys, don't go out and buy expensive paintbrushes. They're going to get destroyed pretty quick with the spray paint and the nature of the solvent in the cans. Go to the dollar store, get yourself 10 brushes for $2, and throw them away as you go. It's not worth painstakingly trying to clean them and tend to the brushes to keep them in good condition. So use cheap stuff. It works just as good for this application. Going in, adding more details, thickening up the trees, making them look kind of unique and different from each other. Now, once you're satisfied with this, you're going to go in with your palette knife again. You're going to add just some highlights. You're not scraping away the trees to make the base. We've already done that with black paint here. All we're going to do is blast some clear coat on and just roll up the light side edge of each tree and each branch. This gives a great detailed effect. It makes these trees really come to life. Alternatively, you can have bright trees in the background like we made first and then just leave these foreground trees black. I do find that adding a little bit of highlights here and there with the palette knife, again, makes them come to life, makes them pop a whole bunch more. When you go in for this part, make sure you're using virtually no pressure. You're going to get a nice sharp line when you do that, and it'll keep the line nice and thin. So you can go in and do some detail work. Once you push down on the palette knife, you're going to thicken up your lines. And that's really good and helpful in certain areas of using this technique. But in others, you really want to make sure you're just using virtually no pressure at all. Or varying the pressure ever so slightly as you go along when you do want a thicker line. That's pretty much it, guys. We're going to go in and add with a fan brush this time, just a bit of grassy textures and effects on here, just to brighten things up and make it not as barren in the foreground. Definitely want it darker than the background here. Just adding little wisps of grass, little pieces of terrain. And always, guys, don't forget to sign your paintings. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hit the like and subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.